We have been reading teachings of Lord Kapila to his mother, Devahuti. And in these two verses, Lord Kapila is describing to his mother, Devahuti, who is a liberated soul. And he says, a liberated soul is he who realizes the presence of the absolute personality of Godhead in everything, even in the material creation. Because he knows that everything that is existing even materially is because of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So this is the highest realization, seeing Krishna in everything. Although Krishna personally is not there, but he sees Krishna in that energy of Krishna because it is an emanation from Krishna. It's an emanation of his energy. And just like the example is given, that when we see the sunlight here in the room, we can think, we can feel, we can see the sun. Although the sun is not directly seen, but because the sunlight is an energy of the sun, we can see the sun. We know that the sun is there. So this is possible, to see Krishna in everything in this material world, only if there is a deep love for Krishna. Otherwise, we will not be able to see Krishna in all its energies. Only possible if there is love. And Prabhupada gives a very nice example of how a mother sees his son or his child whenever she sees anything connected to the child. For example, in the house, if the child, the mother loves the child very much, and when the child has gone to school, the child is not there at home, but when the mother is engaged in some household duties and she sees a small dress of the child or the small shoes of the child, the mother is immediately filled with love. Tears start flowing because she loves the child. She is not seeing the shoes or the dress of the child. She is actually seeing the child. Otherwise, it's not possible for the mother to feel so much love for the child just by seeing shoes. Shoes by itself has got no meaning, right? Dress by itself has got no meaning. But she's not seeing the shoes or the dress. She's actually seeing the child. And that's why the loving tears come out from the mother's eyes. So this is possible only when there is deep love. When in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is further explained, when Ramananda Raya and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu were having an exchange of some conversations about intimate pastimes of Radha and Krishna, we all know that whole night Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramananda Raya would discuss about intimate pastimes of Radha and Krishna. And then one day morning, after discussing these intimate pastimes, Ramananda Raya, he asks Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he says, Mahaprabhu, I have one doubt in my mind. Can you please remove this doubt from my mind? So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked, what is that doubt? So he says, earlier I would see you as a sannyasi. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was a sannyasi at that time. And then later, now, afterwards, I am seeing you as that blackish Krishna, Shyam Sundara. And then later still, I am seeing you as a personality, a wonderful personality with a golden hue, Gauranga. And then I am seeing you as, in this Gauranga form, I am also seeing you with a flute. And you are playing the flute. So in other words, Ramananda Raya is telling Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, earlier I would see you, I was seeing you as a sannyasi, but now I am seeing you as Krishna. So what is the reason for this? Can you please clear this doubt? And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu replies to this. Prabhu kahe, when he asks this doubt, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu replies, Krishna tomar gadha prema hoya. You have deep love. Krishna tomar, you, gadha prema hoya. Gadha means deep. Prema means love, hoya. You have deep love for Krishna. ప్రేమేర స్వభావ ఏయి జానీలో నిశ్చయ. అండ్ ప్రేమేర స్వభావ, బికాస్ యు హ్యావ్ డీప్ ఎక్స్టాటిక్ లవ్ ఫర్ ద లార్డ్, నాచురలీ యు ఆర్ సీయింగ్ థింగ్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ వే. సో ఇన్ అదర్ వర్డ్స్, చైతన్య మహాప్రభు ఇస్ డినైయింగ్. వీ నో చైతన్య మహాప్రభు ఆల్వేస్ డినైడ్ బీయింగ్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ కృష్ణ. హీ వాజ్ హిడెన్, బట్ డివోటీస్ కుడ్ ఈజీలీ ఫిగర్ అవుట్ దాట్ హీ ఈస్ కృష్ణ. సో చైతన్య, సో ఆల్దో రామానంద రాయ సీయింగ్ ఐఎమ్ సీయింగ్, అఫ్ కోర్స్ చైతన్య మహాప్రభు ఇస్ కృష్ణ, బట్ అండ్ రామానంద రాయ సీయింగ్ హిమ్ యాజ్ కృష్ణ, బట్ చైతన్య మహాప్రభు సీయింగ్ నో నో, ఇట్స్ జస్ట్ బికాస్ యూ హ్యావ్ డీప్ లవ్ ఫర్ కృష్ణ ఇస్ వై యు ఆర్ సీయింగ్ థింగ్స్ లైక్ దిస్, యాక్చువల్లీ ఐఎమ్ నాట్ కృష్ణ. అండ్ దెన్ హీ సేస్, మహాభాగవత్ దేఖే స్థావర జంగమ తహా తహా హోయతార్ శ్రీకృష్ణ స్ఫురణ. ఆ మహాభాగవత్ ఆర్ అ ప్యూర్ డివోటీ, వెన్ హీ సీస్ స్థావర జంగమ, వెన్ హీ సీస్ థింగ్స్ మూవబుల్ ఆర్ స్టేషనరీ, స్థావర స్టేషనరీ ఆర్ జంగమ మూవబుల్, హీ జస్ట్ సీయింగ్ కృష్ణ ఎవ్రీవేర్. దిస్ అ సిమ్టమ్ ఆఫ్ అ ప్యూర్ డివోటీ. And then he says this verse which Prabhupada quotes in the previous purport, sthavara jangama dekhe na dekhe tar murti sarvatra hoy nija ishta deva spurti. So pure devotee, when he sees the energy of Krishna, sthavara jangama, sthavara means that is inert, non movable, or jangama, that which is moving. In other words, everything that he sees in the material world, na dekhe tar murti, he's not seeing it as an external manifestation or whatever it appears to be, this table, this mic, he's not seeing it like that. How is he seeing it? Sarvatra hoy, everywhere what he's seeing, nija ishta deva spurti. Ishta deva means the wonderful Lord, nija ishta, because you know our wonderful worshipable Lord is Krishna, so he's seeing it as a worshipable Lord Krishna. And then Prabhupada again writes in this purport that this is due to deep ecstatic love for the Lord that a devotee sees everywhere the Lord and not his energy. Just like the mother, whenever she sees anything of the child, she feels for the child and she doesn't see that. So this is our goal in life, how to develop this deep ecstatic loving relationship with the Lord, love for the Lord. Then we will be able to see the Lord. That is the qualification required to actually see the Lord. Brahma also says the same thing, premanjana churita bhakti vilochanena santa sadaiva hridayeshu vilokayanti yam shyam sundaram achintya gunaswarupam govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami. Premanjana churita bhakti vilochan, when our eyes are anointed with that loving devotion, then Santa, that pure devotee, sadaiva hridayeshu vilokayanti, he is constantly seeing Krishna 24 hours. It is a love for Krishna that has to be awakened, and if that is awakened, then it is possible to see Krishna. So actually, if you have awakened a love for Krishna, you can, you know, it is in everything that we see or we do, we can perceive the presence of Krishna, we can see Krishna. It is very much possible. Like Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita also, rasohom apsu kaunteya prabhasmi shashi suryaho. I am the taste in the water. I am the light of the sun and the moon. So when we drink water, we can actually feel that, yes, this is Krishna. I can see the Lord because the Lord is the taste and it's right there with you. You are drinking it. When you see the light of the sun and the moon, it is Krishna. So for a devotee, there is no difficulty in awakening Krishna consciousness. A devotee doesn't feel, oh, I am in contact with this material nature. Oh, it's risk. Yes, it is for the practicing devotee, understanding that the material nature is dangerous and I must get out of it is the consciousness. But for a pure devotee, everything is an energy of Krishna. So I am seeing Krishna everywhere. So for a pure devotee, it is not difficult to see Krishna, and therefore a devotee finds no difficulty in being Krishna conscious 24 hours a day. Everywhere he is just seeing Krishna. That is why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Sthavara jangama dekhe, na dekhe tar murti. He is seeing so many things, but he is not seeing anything. He is only seeing Krishna.